Today we are continuing with the chapter. In this previous video of the same chapter, previous class, we discussed about the detailed structure of the myofibril. In this you came to know that what is Z-line, what is a sarcomere, what is the H-line, what is M-line, I-band, A-band and their arrangement. Now you know about that. There are two types of proteins which are present in the muscle, that is actin protein and myosin protein. Now, what is the structure of these contractile proteins? Because the contraction of the muscle occurs just because of the activity of these two proteins, actin protein and myosin. Now, just have a look over here. There are two types of protein, contractile protein, actin and myosin. Actin protein is thin and myosin protein is thick. So filaments are thin and thick. Actin is divided into three parts, that it consists of three regions, three parts: actin, troponin and tropomyosin. Next comes the myosin. Myosin protein consists of only single, that is myosin consists of only myosin proteins. Okay. Here is the diagram of a myosin protein. It is consist of two regions. One is the head region and the other region is the tail portion. So this head part, it consists of two parts. It is called as heavy meromyosin. It is consist of heavy meromyosin, and this topmost region of the head, it consists of the actin binding site, the position where this myosin joins with the actin and then helps in the movement of the muscles. So it, the head region, the upper portion, is having the actin binding site, and below it is the ATP binding site because of the presence of enzyme ATPase. ATPase enzyme is present over here, which results in binding with the ATP. Then the tail region, this is the tail region and it is called as light meromyosin. So here you can see that myosin, made up of myosin protein, consists of two regions, head region and tail region. Head region consists of actin binding site, where this head binds with the actin protein and helps in the movement of the muscle. Then below it is the presence of the ATP binding site, that is the enzyme is present and the enzyme name is ATPase enzyme. This region of the head is called as heavy meromyosin and the tail region is called as light meromyosin. Just have a look over the diagram. Now we'll discuss about the actin filament. Now students, here you can see the diagram of actin protein. Actin protein, I tell you, it is called as a thin filament and it consists of three parts: actin, troponin and tropomyosin. Now this is the diagram of actin protein. So it consists of three regions: actin, troponin and tropomyosin. So you can see over here this spherical structures, green marked with green, is called as F actin, and in bracket I have written G actin. Actually, what is the meaning of F and G? Though it is an actin protein, but here G refers to the spherical structure of actin, which we call it as globular actin. It is called as globular actin, and this globular actin, it joins with other globular actin and form a long filament that is called as F actin or filament actin. So now this is the difference between F actin and G actin. Okay, so here we say that actin is what? It is a filamentous actin which is formed by globular actin. Now this F actin, it runs parallel with the tropomyosin. It is another protein, tropomyosin. Tropomyosin and F actin, they run both parallel to each other. And at certain sites of tropomyosin, troponin protein is present. It is not present throughout, but at certain sites troponin protein is present on the tropomyosin. Actually, the role of troponin is that the region where it is present, it is the active site for the attachment of myosin head. Okay, just now we have discussed about the structure of myosin. Myosin has a globular head, and in that globular head, a region is there that is the actin binding site. So this troponin, it is covering the site or the position where globular head of myosin can join. So troponin is what? It is having the actin binding site. F actin is there, which is formed of actin protein. Globular actin combines with each other, form a long filament form called as F actin. And along with the F actin, tropomyosin runs parallel to each other. So this is the structure of actin protein. Now we'll discuss how actin and myosin helps in contraction. Now students, here we are going to discuss about the mechanism of contraction of muscles, and this is best explained by sliding filament theory, which was proposed by A.F. Huxley, R. Nedergurk and H.E. Huxley and Jean Manson. They worked on the muscles and they find out the reason behind the contraction of the muscles. And then they proposed sliding filament theory. Now, what is sliding filament theory? Just have a look over here. Contraction of muscles takes place by the sliding of thin and thick filaments that pass over each other with the help of cross bridge to reduce the length of sarcomere. So here it means that you know about the sarcomere. Sarcomere consists of A band, half I band, and over here also half I band. So this, if I say this half band, half band, this comes to be the functional unit of sarcomere. And this sarcomere consists of actin protein and myosin proteins. As in the previous video, you have seen the diagram of actin and myosin protein arranged at the Z line, and then in between there is M line and H zone or Hansen zone. So in that you have seen that actin and myosin, they are parallel to each other. And when contraction occurs, that means movement of Z line occurs. And this Z line makes the filaments to overlap each other, means a sliding over the each other. And when the sliding occurs, there is formation of cross bridge between the actin and myosin protein. Just now in the diagram you have seen that myosin has globular head. This head has actin binding site along with the ATPase enzyme, or we say ATP binding site. So this globular head, it attaches at the site where troponin are present. For removal of the troponin, calcium ions are required. That means when calcium ions are released, this troponin is removed. So when calcium ion is released, then troponin is removed. Then removal of troponin reveals the position for attachment of myosin head. Myosin head attaches at the position where the troponin was attached. Now, when this ATPase enzyme, it utilizes the energy, and due to that energy utilization, this myosin, it moves the actin filament. So that means over here the binding position is there, and attachment also there, formation of cross bridge is there, resulting in the movement of the actin filament. When this actin filament is moved, then another myosin, it joins, and then it moves the actin filament further. So in this way, when this myosin enzyme, it loses its energy, it leaves the actin and another myosin head joins at the position. So in this way, what will happen? Actin filament is sliding over the myosin. So that's why it is said that this is a sliding filament theory. Now just have a look. Sliding filament theory, contraction of muscles takes place by sliding of the thin and thick filament, that is actin and myosin filaments, that pass over each other with the help of cross bridge to reduce the length of sarcomere. Next up, this theory was proposed by A.F. Huxley and R. Nedeker and H.E. Huxley and Jean Manson in England in 1954. The sequence of events leading to contraction is initiated by CNS, that is central nervous system. Means the message of contraction, it is sent by the central nervous system, that is either the brain or the spinal cord. So that means when message is sent, then only the muscles contract, because we know that here we are talking about the skeletal muscles. And skeletal muscles, they are connected with the bones and they are the voluntary muscles. So for that, what will happen? It is under our will. So here we say that it is under the control of central nervous system, either that is from the brain or spinal cord via motor neuron. Motor neuron is the neuron which bring back the message from the brain or spinal cord to the organ where action is to be done. So now we'll look over here how this process occurs, how the sliding filament theory is used in the movement of the muscles. Now students, just have a look over here on the flow chart, which shows that how the myosin attaches to the actin. So see here, central nervous system is sending the impulses to the motor neuron. Motor neuron is bringing the message back from the central nervous system, and this message is transferred to the muscle. Okay, so this muscle, it becomes active. So here we say that action potential is generated. This action potential, it is transferred to the neuromuscular junction, that means the synapse where the nerve is connected to the muscle. Nerve is connected to the muscle where the nerve endings are connected to the muscle, that is called as neuromuscular junction. So when at this position, what will happen? Neurotransmitter is released, which is a chemical named as acetylcholine. This acetylcholine, it generates action potential in the sarcolemma, that is the plasma membrane of the muscle cell. So plasma membrane of the muscle cell or sarcolemma, it generates the action potential. This action potential or the wave of impulse, it passes to the sarcoplasmic tubule, that is the endoplasmic reticulum of the muscle cell. Now this endoplasmic reticulum, or we say sarcoplasmic tubule of the muscle cell, it is rich in calcium ions. So it contains calcium ions. And when the impulse reaches to the sarcoplasmic tubule, this sarcoplasmic tubule contracts and it releases the calcium ions. These calcium ions, see here, contraction of sarcoplasmic tubule by the action potential, sarcoplasmic tubule is contracted, release calcium ions. These calcium ions, they bind to troponin, and troponin is present in the actin filament. Okay, troponin is a part of actin. So what will happen, and I told you that troponin is the binding site for myosin head. So what will happen, this troponin has covered the binding site of myosin. Now when these calcium ions are released, then this calcium ions, it combines with the troponin and it removes the troponin. When troponin is removed, then the binding site is revealed. binding site of myosin is revealed. So now you see it binds to the troponin, that means calcium ions binds to the troponin, troponin is removed. Now the myosin head joins the F actin. So now here the attachment of myosin head attaches to the F actin filament. So once again, just have a look. Central nervous system send the impulses to motor neuron. Motor neurons send the impulses to the muscle. In muscle, action potential is generated at the neuromuscular junction. Then results in the release of neurotransmitter or acetylcholine, which generates the action potential on sarcolemma. Then sarcoplasmic tubule receives the action potential. And these sarcoplasmic tubules, they contain calcium ions. This action potential in the sarcoplasmic tubules results in the contraction of sarcoplasmic tubules. And when sarcoplasmic tubules are contracted, calcium ions are released. Then these calcium ions, they join or bind to the troponin of the actin. And troponin is removed by revealing the site of attachment of myosin head. So myosin head joins the F actin. So now here comes the attachment of myosin with the actin. Just have a brief look over here on the flowchart. Now students, just see the formation of cross bridge between the actin and myosin. With this flowchart, just have a look. I hope you will understand with this. See here, ATP molecule is released because this is a muscle cell. Muscles have maximum number of mitochondria, and mitochondria provides the ATP, that is the energy currency. So this ATP molecule, it comes through the, it is present at the myosin globular head. It comes at the myosin globular head, and where ATPase enzyme along with calcium and magnesium ion is present. In the diagram you have seen that globular head is there, and this globular head has actin binding site along with the ATPase binding site. Okay, so what will happen, this ATP molecule which is released by the mitochondria, it is provided or it enters into the globular head of myosin, where ATPase enzyme is present along with the calcium and magnesium ions. So this catalyzes the reaction, that means it breaks down the ATP, and inorganic phosphate, adenosine diphosphate, that is ADP, and energy is released. So that means ATP enzyme breaks the ATP. It catalyzes the ATP and results in the production of energy. This energy from the myosin globular head, okay, it is transferred over here to the myosin head, and this myosin head, while getting the energy, though it is in this way, it becomes straight. Okay, so the myosin head becomes straight, and already we know that due to the release of calcium ions from the sarcoplasmic tubule, troponin is removed. Now the action site or the binding site on the actin filament is revealed. So this myosin head, when it becomes straight, it joins to the F actin, the binding site, and when it joins, it forms the cross bridge. So now these cross bridge, it helps in the movement. So movement in the cross bridge occurs, which moves the actin filament towards the center of the A band. That means actin filament is over here and this is the myosin. So it moves the actin filament towards the center of the A band. As a result, what will happen, this actin, when actin is moved, then Z line, it moved or it is pulled towards the inner side. So when Z line is pulled towards inside, we say that the sarcomere has contracted, or we say that contraction in the sarcomere occurs. Now just one
again. Look over here. ATP molecule is provided, or it enters into the myosin globular head, where ATPase enzyme is present. In the presence of, along with calcium ions and magnesium ions, catalyzes the reaction and break down ATP into inorganic phosphate, ADP, and energy. This energy is utilized by the myosin head, and myosin head becomes straight, and when it becomes straight, it joins to the active site on the F actin and form the cross bridges. These cross bridges helps in the movement, and it moves the actin towards the center of the A band. Then when actin is moved, then Z line is also pulled inward and results in the contraction of the sarcomere. Now just have a brief look once again. Now friends, see here, just now I told you that cross bridge is formed between the actin and the myosin. Okay, so what will happen when myosin has shifted the actin? During that time, energy is utilized, and this energy is what? ATP. Now this utilization of energy is done, and when energy is utilized, then what will happen? The energy level of myosin is reduced. When energy level of myosin is reduced, then the attachment between the actin and myosin breaks. That means the cross bridge which is formed between the actin filament and myosin filament, it breaks. Okay, and another myosin, it joins with the actin, and again it moves the actin towards the center of the A band. So just have a look over here, that straight myosin head contains ATP, where ATP is utilized, and this utilization of ATP, it breaks ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate. When this ADP is formed, during that time myosin head loses energy, and when energy is lost, then the cross bridge formed between the actin and myosin, it breaks. But this cycle of attachment of myosin head with the actin, it continues because many myosin are present, many myosin heads are present which joins with the actin and results in the movement or the sliding of the actin filament. So it is a repeated cyclic process. So here we have done with the sliding filament theory. Now we have discussed about the contraction. Now see what will happen when the contraction has occurred. Okay, when the contraction in the sarcomere has occurred, or the Z line has, means the unit or the length of the sarcomere is become shortened. After that, what will happen, that calcium ions which had bind with the troponin, calcium ions which had bind with the troponin to relieve the actin binding site. So these calcium ions, they separate from the troponin and they enter back to the sarcoplasmic tubule. Calcium ions separate from the troponin and enter into the sarcoplasmic tubule or the endoplasmic reticulum of the muscle cell. Then what will happen? Troponin are left behind. These troponin bind again to their position, and then the length of the sarcomere increases. That means causes the relaxation of the sarcomere. So here what will happen in the relaxation process, that troponin which were bound or binded by the calcium ions, when the sarcomere length has contracted to its limited strength, so after that what will happen, calcium ions, they separate from the troponin, and troponin bind to the actin position, actin filament, where the binding site of myosin is there. Okay, so this troponin is join the actin filament, and myosin is released from there, and then the Z line length increases, sarcomere length increases,
resulting in the relaxation of the muscles. So here we have completed with the chapter. This was the last topic, and the skeletal system or the skeletal system we won't do because that is not included in the syllabus. So that's all for in this chapter.